Dreamer's Road is the debut solo release by Freddie Kirchy. Joined by guitarist and 15-year cohort Steve DeMarkey, Freddie's is the soulful voice that once fronted such bands as Alias and Sheriff. Today we're at EMI Capitol Records, and we're going to have the opportunity to speak to Steve and Freddie about their new album, Dreamer's Road, the first single, which is a rendition of Van Morrison's Brown Eyed Girl, and exactly what they've been doing over the past 4 years.
Well, Steve was in Sheriff before I was.
Yeah, I was one of the founders of Sheriff, me and the keyboard player Arnold Lanny. We auditioned like, 30, 40 singers before we actually ran into Freddie. And
didn't want me in the band.
I didn't want him in the band. I didn't like his hairstyle.
Didn't like my haircut.
Well, we were all these long. Everybody had long hair, and Freddie had short hair.
I was a kid back then. We were all kids back then.
So once we heard his voice, it was like, this is the guy, definitely.
He actually had to go to my parents' place and ask their permission to get me in the band.
Oh, you're kidding.
Yeah. He's got to quit college, quit his part-time job, quit his wedding band. I used to be in an Italian wedding band, and he's got to come on the road. My mother fainted. Boom! One of those. And we did the Sheriff thing for 6 years. Then we, after Sheriff, was 3 years of writing and developing our craft as writers, and then we put together the Alias thing.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're doing, Steve's like half of me now.
So the new album has actually come out under your own name. I'm curious to know why it is that you didn't put it under the name of Alias, as you both are actually Alias.
Yeah, it's a long story. The songs. Basically, Steve and I kept writing songs, and they tended to lean further and further and further and further away from an Alias record. I mean, you couldn't put Brown Eyed Girl on an Alias album. And for instance, a song like Diamonds couldn't really fit the Alias format. Alias is a great band. It'd probably be another Alias album happening, but it had its limitations. Credo has always been the best songs make the record. There's no real compromise, and we're fortunate that our record company and our management company also believed in that, and we wanted to make the best product possible. And I guess it took this long, but we're really pleased with the outcome. You know, it's a very fluid record. The thing I dig about the most about the record is that it isn't 11 of the same song over and over again.
Right.
It's a real cool listening experience. You've got to listen to the whole album to really catch the vibe, you know.
Right. Now, the first single is Brown Eyed Girl.
We actually had planned on releasing another single as the first single. Mm-hmm. And I guess the last recording session we had, it was all planned out. They were actually working the new single, the first single, to radio and telling people about the new record. And we had an hour and 20 minutes left. Now, this was, you got to remember, we were actually doing bed tracks. This was our dream band of top-notch new musicians that we were having a lot of fun with.
Right.
And actually having fun recording down in Los Angeles. So Steve said, listen, we used to do Brown Eyed Girl in sound checks, in Alias, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So I said, as a bonus track, let's just lay it down really quick. We'll have a lot of fun. Well, to make a long, long story short, we recorded the song, finished it, and the record company heard it and loved it and said, stop the presses. This is going to be our first single.
Now, what do you think made the creation of Dreamer's Road different than any other project that you've done before?
The songs, just the kind of subject matter, the lyric, especially in Dreamer's Road. I guess Dreamer's Road is basically an autobiographical statement of the last 2.5, 3 years of of us just being, not being in the limelight, not performing live, sitting there trying to make the best record possible, and you've got, at that point, you've got no one else except yourself to believe in. You've got to keep on going, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a beautiful story, but interesting, Dreamer's Road. Home for a week, Steve comes up with this incredible track. It's like, all done. And it's like, well, let's write some lyrics and some melody to it. And it was that kind of thing where we had time to allow the songs to quote Steve, ferment, you know, and really become good pieces, you know? It's very simple. Almost
now,
boring.
Yeah. Now, in promoting this record under your own name,
mm-hmm.
do you think that's going to make things different for you? Because now all of a sudden people are finding out actually who is the voice behind Sheriff and behind Alias.
Well, that was the whole idea, to put a name and a face to those songs, for instance, More Than Words Can Say, and the Sheriff song, When I'm With You. We will be performing both songs live, you know,
mm-hmm.
and we're proud of those projects. And I'm just really lucky that Steve and I are together still working this whole thing. But it's, again, it's based down to the songs. The reason, not even close to answering your question, I apologize for that.
That's all right. We can forgive you.
Yeah, it's that simple. It's just basically to put a name to the stuff.
What do you think is the best thing about being a musician in the 90s?
The best thing?
Yeah, what's the best thing?
Well, for us, I mean, it's just being able to, you know, I mean, we've been together for 15 years and be able to stay in this business this long through all the different changes of styles and trends and all that kind of stuff, and
right.
still put out records and hopefully be successful in this one as much as we were in the last one.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a lot of fun being in this business. We've always loved it, and I don't know.
So, see, so we've been musicians in the 70s, 80s, and 90s, and it's always been the best as long as we can play. You know?
You're giving away your age now.
Uh-oh. Well, I was 4 when I joined Sheriff.
I never cared for nobody like I cared.
Toronto right now, Freddie Kirchy would still be holding that note. And